A natural disaster, an earthquake, a flood, or a hurricane, it could happen at any time, and it's often totally unexpected. And during an event like that, it could be that power goes down, it could be that roads are inaccessible, but often we're finding that people with mobile phones still have some limited battery left, and often that could be their only form of communication. So the field of crisis response ranges from, in definition, could mean people who are physically responding to disasters, but it could also mean people who are digitally responding to disasters. There's an emerging need to make sure that people's everyday tools that they're used to using are the same tools that are useful during a time of crisis. So if you're used to using Google search to find information, it makes sense that you would use that same tool, search, in order to learn about something after a natural disaster. The goal of Google Crisis Response is to make information available to users immediately before, during, and after a crisis. Our team provides solutions and tools to everyday users that ideally help them stay out of harm's way and help them to make good decisions to take care of themselves, their friends, and their family during natural disasters. That information should be relevant to users and it should be actionable. They should be able to take that information and do something with it.
When approaching any problem, it's important not to just build a solution that's specific to the one instance of the problem you have in front of you. So it's important to always think how you can build solutions that are general and flexible enough they can easily adapt to handling many different instances of similar problems.
A flood and an earthquake are two completely different types of disasters. Someone in the United States might experience a particular type of event completely differently than somebody who lives, say, in the Philippines. So when building technology, we need to make sure that we build something that applies to multiple types of disasters, many different types of users. But at the same time, we want it to be relevant to any given person, so that that person can find what they need for that situation. So what's amazing is that even a small team like ours can build something that has the potential to impact millions of people.
One challenge our team has is how to measure the impact of our products. How do we know whether they're actually achieving their goals? We want to make sure that any information we provide to our users is actually relevant to them. Some of these things are not so easy to measure, so we have to come up with creative ways to try and evaluate them.
We wanted to find a measurement or metric to help guide our team's work. So after doing internal and external research, we found a metric that tries to measure how much harm is reduced before, during, and after a disaster. In addition, we analyzed lots of data, such as the information needs and what people are searching for before a disaster hits. After doing our analysis, we found that for us, focusing on early warnings is really where we could have much more impact, and specifically around disaster types, tropical storms and floods, because they have such a high vulnerable population globally.
One of the solutions we've developed is public alerts, which tries to provide early warning in time of disaster by getting official emergency bulletins from forecasting agencies and bringing them to potentially affected users. Even after a disaster has passed, our work isn't done. We need to evaluate the impact that we had to see if we're reaching the goals that we set for ourselves. For example, how many of the users in the affected area did we reach with our alerts? And of those that we reached, did they find our alerts useful?
When you're building a technology or solution, it's important for you to measure your impact and make sure you're meeting your goals.
Without understanding the user, you could provide all the information in the world and the user wouldn't be able to absorb it.
It's really the power of data and the internet that makes our work possible on a global scale. And it's through constant measurement and evaluation that we can make our solutions better over time.
Computational thinking is critical to any computer scientist's job. Being able to take a problem, break it down into many different sized pieces, work on each one individually, and eventually bring it all together to solve something, that's a skill that can benefit anyone, even beyond computer science.